Irish. Okay. Serious problems or threats in the comments until the road is deemed safe. There is Tampa. Okay. Threat assessment report. Small arms attack. IED. Mortar teams. Okay. Shit. Get that. Romeo 7. Same as last time, loss of coming. Classic times. Okay. That is good. Yeah. Mission planner. God damn it. CPU 103. Okay, and 3 and 4. I'll leave like that. Keep them with that bombs. Okay. So good. Dodger Roger, hey, thank you for the host. 43 viewers in the channel of non-excellence. Thank you for that. I hope you know what you're doing. So, well, okay, I don't know from which game you're coming. Did you stream, hey Jericho, did you stream DCS earlier? Are your viewers familiar with DCS World? War Thunder. So, well, that is something different here, but you know that. Some should be. Okay, so, gentlemen, I'll give you a quick overview here before we dive into that. I'm playing a single-player campaign, which is called Operation Piercing Fury. It's made by Rangers 79, I guess. And our job is to fly close air support for Romeo 7. Romeo 7 will depart here and clear the major supply route Irish, drive over here and clear that, and then drive down there. I will try to provide CAS for that. So, and therefore, I adjusted my loadout. Hawk 1, that's me. Hawk 2, my wingman, got a special loadout. I adjusted that. And these two guys, it's the element, I gave them a separate loadout. The AI here in DCS has the habit of crashing itself into mountains. I lost 2 A-10s in the mission earlier because they just crashed into the mountains. So I think I'll fly here and let them orbit here somewhere, or probably here. And I just fly with the wingman. And if there is need for it, I will call in the element. So, there's a proper documentation on that mission.
here that comes with the single player campaign. I read the most important things. Looks like that. That's the route of Romeo 7. This is Romeo 7. Reaper Flight will provide cap as well, cast as well. That's the overview of the AO, and that's the threat assessment for the last 60 days. So a lot of stuff is happening here. We will probably have some contacts with the enemy. That is FOBSUSE. I will probably see FOBSUSE later on. So we dive into the mission. I'm gonna have some food and give the cat some fuzz. Yeah, do that. Dodger Roger. Thanks again for the host. And I think we start. As said, it's a single player mission. It's heavily scripted, and a lot of voiceovers, so I hope you don't mind that I don't have the radio, the music too loud here. So we dive in. I have to tell you, I'm not the best pilot. This is not without reason the channel of non-excellence, but I have some decent amount of hours in the A-10C, so I generally know what I'm doing and generally know why I die when I die. So feel free to ask questions. I just don't guarantee to be always able to read the chat. Mission comes first, and if there is time, I will try to explain what I did and why I did it like that. So,
Flight Whiplash 1. Your mission tonight is to provide recon and CAS if needed for ASO Recon Unit Romeo 7, consisting of four Humvee gun trucks. Romeo 7 will be departing Seuss through the northwest gate, call sign Golf 22, to clear the north and west routes along MSR Irish. MSR Irish will be used for a convoy scheduled later in the evening.
I do.
As a reminder, SIGINT and human
Welcome,
reports
FSX.
Indicate several
FX
terrorist groups in the
Electro.
region are planning a massive attack on the TIV to free our guest.
And yes, Kevlar, I'm eating correctly. I'll eat bread, coffee, and butter. And sometimes salt.
Sometime in the immediate future. Stay vigilant. Break. RV Waypoint 1, mark Seuss on your TAD and await further instructions. ROE is to hold fire unless instructed by Romeo 7 Convoy Commander or higher command. Hopefully it'll be uneventful evening. Stay frosty. Watch our boy 6. Whiplash 1 out.
I'm always frosty. Always. Shit! I didn't change my skin. Yeah, I wanted to fly with that skin here, but yeah, well, whatever. That is spooling up. I never crash. Well, and I never lie as long as I tell the truth. And it's
Pull up,
not
pull up.
defueled here, god damn it.
Altitude, altitude.
Fuck. But the loadout is at least what I want. Start cycle is over. Can start the right engine. Fuel is up. SAS. Turn that on. Turn that on. Turn that on. And then I have 1, 3, 4. We save that on 1. Click here on 2, 1, 3, 5. Save that here. And then we go on preview. That is good. I want to hear 33 FM. It's good. Basically, I don't need SRS, so I just disconnect it. Good. Display modes. I want to have a radar altimeter tape, and we're good. Check back. 30-minute combat mix. Fuck. Fly over it. That's pretty close to cool. Yeah, I guess so. So that's pretty bad, actually. I wanted to have like the high explosive incendiary. Somehow I didn't take it. Both engines are running. I look good. Let's go ahead and program the flare programs. I'll talk you through real quick. I have a I don't know what comes at me program containing two chaff and two flare on each press. I have a fuck your radar missile program, which is like one chaff, four chaffs at one press, and I have a fuck you IR missile program. It's four flares at each press. Then I have a I give you a hard time for the next 25 cycles fucking Strela program. And I have a hello, I'm here program, which pops out one flare at one press. So these are my flares and chaff programs. Close that. Alignment is on its way. Let's call request the SAM from print.
Center 9, Hog 1, Flight of 4810, we're starting up at Katasi. What is the status of the SAM footprints at Katasi, sir?
2030, he'll probably give me like a 5 minutes here.
Hog 1, Defender 9, footprints are being posted at this time. Give us 10 mics for a sit rep. Defender 9 out.
Oh, fuck you, 10 minutes. Okay, at 2040, we should know what is going on. So eventually go for that.
Request refueling.
We got time for that.
Request rearming.
So finally I got my thing here. Yeah, that's good. Okay, that is working. Our alignment is through. So, we finish our startup. All the lights are off. We have that. And I'm about to put that in. Set up my slew rate of my mini stick, which I usually put at 2.5. Click that in here and we're good. We could delete that. But basically, I eventually need the CDU here. And I like the Maverick here. We're good. Good. That's okay. I still got 8 minutes. What else can we click? There's a lot of clicking stuff here. We have tuned 33 FM, it's on manual. We have 251, it's on manual. And we have here preset 135 and 134, which is on one. So we could actually go ahead and call ATC and ask Kutaisi if they let us do the startup.
Hog 1-1, request startup. Hog 1,
Good. So we need to load that. We load the dismiss again because we changed our ammunition. Oh, look at that. What are they doing? Oh, is that? Oh shit, I got labels on here. Turn that off. Okay, labels are off. Good. We got it. It's still combat mix. Wait. High explosive, we have that. So, okay, we try to set it. We set that here on weapons. Ammo type. High explosive, incendiary. Store. Exit. Now we got it. Alright. So that means, like, if I have a combat, if I have a combat mix, if I have combat mix, I get two different types of ammunition in my barrel here, and or in the ammo drum, and they have like different flight characteristics. So that means it gives me two pippers, and I don't like two pippers here right now, and I think I'm not killing tanks here. And therefore, oh, we got fog here. I just see it now. We don't have tanks, so I'll take the high explosive incendiary. So, two JDAMs, 42 unguided missiles. Yeah, we need to set that here. This is a CBU-105 RPM. Thousand. Well, I had a function. Go for 1200. Okay. So the CBU 103 is basically that one, a canister bomb with a lot of bomblets, and you can choose the speed of the rotation and the altitude at which it opens. And depending on the higher the altitude and the faster it rotates, the wider is the footprint of the bomb. And it's a little bit of guesswork because I don't have data here, but usually they're pretty good against the infantry. So I hope I'll kill some shit with that. So that is running. I can turn off my APU. And what I have here, will repeat? No, I don't need. So then I go to profiles. I want it down because I usually go to the left side. I'll cycle through that. So I'll start at the bottom. These are my things here. Then I'll like to have my Mark 82. Then I have that comes late. My break. That's pretty good. I'll keep that. Okay, and I want to adjust that program. Most of the time I'll deliver it at CCIP. That is good, but I don't want to have single shot. Wait. No, not Maverick. This one. I don't want to have single, I want to have ripple, single, and basically seven. Yeah, ripple, single, number seven, which each depressed pickle button, it fires a salvo of seven rockets. Can do that exactly six times. That's good. It's pretty good to suppress ground units. Like to turn that on and this on. Three more minutes until I get my footprint here, the SAM footprint, and then we can take off. So, There's something more I'd like to do. Waiting for something. Something. I just did something. I have no idea what. Just did something. Okay. I want to do something else here. So I bring up my waypoint page. And I want to copy the waypoint 3 to waypoint 3. I'll make an easy waypoint. I call it TGT.
Defender 9, footprints posted. Katasi AO swept and secured. Be advised we have two QRF helos at Angels 1. One click out from Katasi, orbiting the AO.
That is good.
Happy hunting. Defender 9 out.
Good. Okay, now I want to adjust. No, I want to add. I want to add that here. What was it? Waypoint 4? Waypoint 4. I want to add waypoint 4 to my flight plan. That was a mistake. It's waypoint 3. Okay, it's waypoint 3. Good. Now my flight plan contains of waypoint 2 and 3 on the same coordinates. So for example, if I put up that waypoint here and I need to override it with coordinates, if I get coordinates, I'll just type in the coordinates here and then I can put them right into here. Now let me see, what do I have here? I don't need all that. In case I need to write something down. That's basically my digital kneeboard here. So, more I don't need. I guess we're good. Bring up TGP, turn it on, latch on. That is good. Let me see, how is the contrast here? Contrast is good, but I think I might get a little bit more contrast. Black hot, white hot, looks good. Recenter, bring up the CDU. Turn that off, go back to stat, TAD, and I guess we're good. Bring up the flight plan. Good to go. Let's ask Kutaisi if we're allowed to taxi.
Kutaisi, Hog 1-1, request taxi to runway.
Come on, Kutaisi. God damn it, I have to drive a long way. All right, Hawk 1-1, taxi, Kutaisi traffic, Hawk 1-1, taxi runway 26. Idea where it goes here. Where do I have to go? Okay, that is 08. Oh, I have to drive all the way over there. Oh fuck! Come on. Eventually, I cut that out of the video here. Ooh, it's pretty hot in here. Those of you who know me a little bit longer, I will probably find it strange that I take so that it that I take the burden of taxiing to the right correct runway. I usually don't do that. Nice driving game, yeah, try. True. If you you know, with VR you can stick your head outside the cockpit. Somebody remind me to change frequency after taking off from Kutaisi to 135. Would be nice. I usually tend to forget that. Do I have to go off here? Yeah, oh well. Central delivering point. No. No, no. I just ordered my fencing suit. My protective gear. So I got enough Santa presents for this year. No VR for me. Hey, Bizno, howdy. Hey, nice that you show up. Man, you won't believe it. You know, yesterday about that Operation Piercing Fury, I thought, well, okay, I could fly that again, because when I saw that at your stream, things like, might be nice to fly a campaign again. And today in the morning, I thought, well, I got some money on my PayPal left, so I decided to go on the website and just purchase it. And then I tried to purchase it, tried to click the button, and it said, bought. I said, what bought? I want to buy it. It says bought. And then I checked my history, and I actually bought it back in 2016. So I basically had that. And then I decided to just fly it. I flew today the mission 1 and 2 in the morning, and this is mission 3 now. You might want to rewatch some things from mission 1 or 2 if you like. Yeah, I guess so. I still had a lot of fun. Already had a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun waiting for my guys here. They're taxiing their asses off here. Yeah, I didn't get 100% in the second mission because my flight number, my wingman and the element lead, no, the element wingman, they killed themselves. They killed themselves by flying into a mountain. So, yeah, I didn't get 100%. And you see, I modified the loadout. I don't take 84 rockets. I just go with 42 rockets. One G-Maverick just for the lols. And an additional Mark 82. One CBO-103 here. In compensation for the missing rockets, and I put on just 70% of fuel instead of 90, and I switched to HEI ammunition. Yeah, Daniel, I guess so. Then we're gonna get to mission 11. Yeah, that will take some time. Now, and for that mission, I decided to just take off, give the element the the order to actually just anchor somewhere, and if my wingman dies or I need additional firepower, I'll call them in. Good. Request takeoff.
Hog 1-1. Request takeoff.
Hog 1-1. Patsy, you are cleared for takeoff already. Climb 300 at QSE 29.58.
Good. This time we take off. We go for. Are you going to do mission 12? Nice. But yeah, now actually I can't watch it now. It will spoil it. But this time actually I take flap stage 1. I forgot that and take off at the last mission. So let's spool up that thing here at 80%. See if the engines are running good. Ah, nice. So I'm looking forward at mission 11. Suspense, you mean a surprise? No, it does not have a. Oh, yeah, we got crosswind here. It does not have an A-10, a Phantom yet. Flaps up. Did they get shot down, basically, Bizno, or did they crash? Mace had a payload on a Falcon carrier as a 760. Yeah. Yeah, actually, yeah, I think you might learn one or two things by watching it, but for new people, it's basically nothing because I don't explain what I do. So things are just changing here. And I don't say what buttons I press, so. But when you see what I do, you will know which button I actually pressed. For example, like this. You know why I'm now looking directly at Suze. There is too much? Okay. They didn't do proper safe escape maneuvers here. These are the choppers. Yeah, well, yeah, you gotta give him time. They're just not good at it. Okay, so we fly at Angel 6 here. Flight formation trail.
Flight, go trail.
go for one more circle and give them the chance to actually catch up here. Chat in the main window, that is Twitch2DCS, Google Twitch2DCS Jabbers. It's something he wrote back in the days when he was streaming VR and he wasn't able to read the chat, so he decided to do that. Or if somebody is here who actually knows where to find Twitch2DCS, you can put in a link in the chat, please. That would be nice. Namen Wiesel. Ah, yeah, you can talk to Kevlar. He knows a lot about the reverb. Bah, da musst du gucken. Ich weiß nicht, bei der A10 blende ich das nie aus. Bei der F18 ist es, glaube ich, Backspace. Aber du kannst mal gucken hier. Komm, das können wir gerade mal machen. Ich helfe dir, damit du dir in Zukunft selber helfen kannst. Adjust Controls. Search. Hide. Hide. Control Stick. Control. Stick. Oh, I think that doesn't work in the A10. Stick. Stick to trim control mode. No. So I don't think that this is possible in the A10. Basically, in the F18, it is called control stick hide show. It's backspace. Let's try back again in the A10C. Control. No chance. Don't get control stick. Einen Steuerknüppel auswählen, das Kniebrett aufrufen. Kniebrett habe ich mir Tasten belegt. Und zwar die hier. Kneeboard. And you gotta look. Just search for kneeboard or kniebrett. Running thingy. Wait. Clear noise. Hello, and high pitch Eric. Hello. It's in the other settings thingy. In the other settings thingy gameplay. You really think so? Nah. Okay. Maybe. I haven't had the problem in the A-10C yet, because you don't need that very often, and it's very easy accessible here. On the offsite, yeah, you can ask. I hope I can answer it. If not, there are a lot of people here in chat who know.
Yeah, it's a plane or it's a pack with missions.
It's Flame Eclipse 3. It's a pack of planes. Maybe there are some missions in there. I don't know exactly, but it's the Flaming Cliffs modules. They're not as detailed as, for example, a DCS module. It's, for example, the F-15, MiG-29, Su-27. They're pretty nice from the flight model side, but they're not clickable. It's a pack of planes. You get the A-10A, for example, as well. If somebody's planning on buying the Su-33 or the MiG-29, I'd always recommend to actually buy Flame Eclipse 3.
Oh. Tonight's scheduled convoy has already been delayed multiple times in the last 48 hours due to the various threat reports we've received regarding imminent attacks in the region. However, this convoy is resupplying coalition forces in the western region of the AO who are desperately low on supplies, and it cannot be canceled again. I've requested additional air cover consisting of two AH-64 Apaches, callsign Reaper 22, to provide recon and additional CAS in and around MSR Irish and Seuss. Reaper 22 should be on station once Romeo 7 leaves the wire. No need to acknowledge Whiplash 1 out.
Yeah, I generally, if you did not check it, or if you did not install or buy anything yet, I always recommend to go for the real version, not the Steam version. You wait a lot longer for modules, for patches and for everything. There's basically not a single, oh well, there are maybe some reasons why you want to go on Steam. Rolling out TIF Golf Northwest. Okay, that's the wrong side. That's somewhere here. Golf 22, it's here. Northwest. Okay, so basically I'm right. There he is. Oh, nice. He has that.
Units, Reaper 22, flight of 2 on station. Visual on Romeo 7, Oscar Mike. Reaper 22 out.
10 hours. Well, then you did something wrong. It doesn't take 10 hours. Three miles. Okay, so I think that's a pretty good radius. 3 miles. Let's bring the convoy on the 3 line on the 3 o'clock position. Good. Norbert, 1699. Is this the free plane? No. This is the first DCS. No, well, basically the second DCS module, which was viable back in 2010, 11, something like that. It's the A-10C. Has a fully clickable cockpit. And it is worth every dollar. So, if the plane would cost $1,000 and I would have to calculate a price per hour played, I would pay less than $1. Just go on and turn that on, just in case. And we're already in a mission. So. And look at that. There is that Reaper flight. What is it? What is it called? Reaper flight, yeah, okay. Convoy is driving towards northwest. Somewhere down there. Oh, wait. Somewhere here? No, somewhere here, I guess. See, do I see him? Somewhere here. There are the choppers, and there is my convoy somewhere. Good. Where's basically the sun? The sun is there. That is west. So the sun's setting in the west, which is nice. Daniel, how are you planning to buy A-10C? Yeah, I'll buy the Super Tucano. I guess it's a fun plane, and you probably can use it. It probably finds good use in a lot of missions. So, we're trying to stay somewhere between 2.5 miles and 4 miles. Mutual support distance. Hey, Phipps. Grüß dich. Nee, es ist eine Singleplayer-Campaign, es ist unwahrscheinlich. So, convoy is down there. Always try to keep eyes on the convoy that you know where you have to roll in. Happy Jerick? Ah, yeah. Exactly. No, it's not. It's buyable. Therefore, it's not free. So, I got a good visual here on that. We stay below the cloud cover. I could actually try to set that up here. That's a pretty good fighting plane. It's a Flaming Cliffs 3 model. It's not clickable, but it's a very important and very versatile aircraft, which is basically in most of the multiplayer missions. It's built in most of the multiplayer missions, so you can participate in the online fray with that one. And then you have, you have the TF-51, which is basically a civilian version of the P-51 Mustang, a prop plane on DCS level standard with clickable cockpit and all that shit, which is really nice to fly, but you can't shoot with it. But there are some servers which actually utilize the TF-51 as a recon airplane or an airplane which you can capture bases and shit. So, convoy is down there in that turn here. Yeah, right here is the convoy. Convoy does strange things. Clear that for the chase. Alright, nah, this is only slow. This is the only slow mission. Really? But I'll get to shoot stuff, I hope so. Oh shit. I'm not allowed to, shit, come on. Tell me, I'd like to kill stuff.
All units, Reaper 2-2, visual on enemy troops in the open. Beginning rocket run south to north at this time. Reaper 2-2 out.
Okay, Reaper 2-2 is doing that, so all good. Eyes back on the convoy. Convoy just drove in here. Convoy. Always keep him on the 3 o'clock. Funny shit. It's the first radar warning tone in that mission. Oh, fuck. Yeah, push RP Juliet. It's good. Do that. bring you back on my 3 o'clock convoy. I don't want to get too far. Don't want to be too close, but don't want to be too far either. Too close, not enough time and room to actually turn in and be effective. Too far, well, it's too far out to be effective. Shit. That doesn't sound good. Where are the fucking light armored vehicles? There we go.
Foxtrot Sierra, just tip ops 1. We'd have BBID explode.
Warning, autopilot.
We have released 12 coalition casualties, a fender has been breached, 3 of our guard charges severely damaged. We have reports that 8 to 10 detainees from Compound 6 have escaped, fleeing west. We are being ambushed by foot mobiles and light armored vehicles from outside the perimeter, from northwest and west. The tip has erupted in riots, your weapons red. We're unable to prevent any other escapes. Get these enemy forces off our ass to the northwest and west flanks. We'll be conducting a head count as soon as we get this goddamn riot stopped. Tip ops 1 out.
Guess so.
Agent.
Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Altitude! Altitude!
75% in the first round.
Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude. Pull up, pull up.
Maybe there in the trees.
Pull up.
Oh, I see shit.
Pull up, pull up.
Oh shit, he's close. Fuck, he was close. Good. Target destroyed is always good. West of the TIFF, two small jeeps. Copy.
One. Break off from Cass and get eyes on those two jeeps. Last report was the two jeeps were heading south from an apartment block which is located just west of the TIFF. Conduct surveillance to maintain higher altitude. Do not engage. I say again, do not engage. Don't spook them. Break. If these are in fact the escaped detainees, they could lead us to the motherlode. The FOB attack was well coordinated, and we have reports that many terrorist organizations and tribes, which are usually at each other's throats, had joined forces in the raid. We need to find the mastermind. He might be the next UBL in the region. Whiplash One out.
Flash One, this is Uniform One. Target vehicles heading east, southeast on railroad tracks. Uniform One out.
Hawk 1-1 got eyes on him. Got a sensor on him. I try to keep eyes on him.
Flash 1, this is Uniform 1. Target vehicles have turned onto MSR Tampa and are heading southwest. Uniform 1 out.
Copy, southwest. Hog 1-1, still got eyes and sensors on it. Finger of God. Night missions are actually really, really good. Gotta get below cloud cover here. It feels a little bit like those car chases and US-American news shows with the chopper. Oh, it feels a little bit like that. No, the Jeeps are still driving. Jeeps are still driving down there. That's why I love night missions here in the Hawk. Time to put in another mark point. I'd drive somewhere else.
Cloud flight with Flash 1, this is Uniform 1. Target vehicles have turned off of MSR Tampa and are heading south, southeast into a residential area. Uniform 1 out.
Roger. Drunken Bear, hello. I'll soon try to read what you wrote. I've got the A-10C in two campaigns, basic training, reacquire targets, and advanced training one. It's a good start to learn this jet. Yeah, probably. probably. I can't say that because when those missions came out, I was already proficient in the A-10. Getting dark. I don't want to follow a helicopter, but hey. There's the helicopter coming. I did a lot of mark points on my way here.
Hog flight, Whiplash 1, this is Uniform 1. Unknown, helicopter has landed and 8 personnel from the target vehicles are boarding. Confirmation on MI-24, Uniform 1 out.
Probably don't have enough fuel for that mission.
Copies.
Ian, 24, hello. I should know you could see the laser. You don't see the laser, you see the infrared pointer. You see the infrared pointer with that here. Or you have to turn it on. Shit. He told me to fly high. It is a pretty cool detail. Just don't fucking lose that thing here. God damn it. I'm really afraid here. It's getting difficult. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Fuck. Fuck. I lost that fucking helicopter. Fuck! It was flying west. Yeah, broke lock. It's flying somewhere over there. Shit! Shit, fuck. I wanna find that thing again. But he's fast. He's probably flying somewhere east. Nah, I don't have AIM-9s. I got a gun. Don't need AIM-9s. But we could actually try searching it with M9. But fuck. Fuck. Yeah, I think so. That would be a pretty fucking hard mission if the mission would now be fucked for that. I'm just climbing now here, Angels 8 or so. I'm going in an orbit. This one, UHF, flight, rejoin.
Flight, join up.
Wait a second. Oh yeah, two's there. So, what I find a little bit strange that obviously that convoy thing here got deleted. I don't see him anymore here on... Oh wait, maybe it's that one. But that is...
With Flash 1, this is Uniform 1. The MI-24 has landed at coordinates 32438734 26. The Tangos are exiting the helo. We have several unknown personnel standing by the LZ. Uniform 1 out.
Uh-huh, fuck. 32438734 26.
Oh, wait. All personnel at the LZ, including that Hind. We've got coordinates for the location. Give them hell. Whiplash 1 out.
Lima... What was it? Hi, Ian. Oh, wait. Oh. Okay. So, that was... Lima Mike. 32438734 26. Target. Just getting into this advanced joystick, what would you recommend should be the first plane I buy? Do you want to learn a lot? If you want to learn a lot, 107. Okay. If you want to learn a lot, read a lot, and have a steep learning curve, you probably should buy the A-10C. If you don't want to learn a lot, just go with the standard planes. Because that thing is not flying anymore.
All flights, Whiplash 1, outstanding job. We still have control of the FOB and the region thanks to your heroics today, gentlemen. However, we did lose some brave men and women. But we have weakened the terrorist stranglehold in the region and sent a lot of dirtbags to meet Allah. With the new intel gathered today, we'll be striking deeper into the tribal regions, and in the days, weeks, and months to come, we'll be striking directly at the terrorist leadership in the region. RTB, get some chow and rest. They'll be busy as hell in the next few months. The battle was won today, but the war is far from over. Proud Papa. Whiplash 1 out.
Good.
Posted. Katasi AO swept and secure. We'll stay on the net if anything changes. Defender 9 out.
Good. Send him home. Let's see what happens. Navigation, return home.
Flight, RTB.
Okay. Now I can basically go back on Yep, see ya. See. 5. Kutaisi inbound.
Kutaisi. Hog 1-1. Inbound.
Hold 1-1.
Yeah. Okay, 50 something like this, right? Yeah, it's a little bit broken right now. That's why I'm grinding. It's pretty useful. A lot of planets are less limited. Sniper, you bomb ship from miles away. Yeah. It's pretty much what Ian says.
Landing.
Such a long final. The longer the final, the more is the chance to actually fuck it up. Quacks, ich mache jetzt hier die Mission fertig und dann kurze Rauchpause und dann komme ich auf den Server. Meinst du nicht STP-9?
Altitude.
It was okay. With the A-10 you have the good work right and do not exit the mission once like increase mission points. Yeah, we increase mission points. It's a little bit difficult in the A-10 to actually get the feeling for the flare point when you need to flare, because it is so damn high that you think, I got hundreds of feet until I have to wait a second, we have some light here. Hundreds of feet to the touchdown, but then it turns out you're already touching down. We didn't need most of the... Oh, look at that. Next talk is already down. have no idea where I need to go. I just turn right here. Just lands, just park somewhere. I don't know. Probably because somebody didn't complain enough on the ED forums. That's probably the reason. No, I have no idea. It could be brighter, it's true. Now I see DCS as a steadily and continuously improving piece of software. And when I finally retire, it will be pretty much there where all the people like to have it right now. So, alright. Now here, the light post of death. 50% feature complete. The light posts of death. Let's try. Let's try this time. Let's try this time not to fuck it up. It just takes some. Just take anyone here. Okay, there is a light post. Pretty much straight, pretty much straight. It's not perfectly on the line, but it's okay. Hey, at least this time the jet is not broken. Yeah, I was trying to get a very good parking position. I just was looking like left and then suddenly fucked up the right wing of the light post here. First mission, but on the part where, yeah, I cut that out. Well, I cut that out, but not specifically because of that, because it doesn't make sense. Just to wait for that. But hey, the stream is there. You can watch it. Good. So let me see real quick. Oh, is my coffee? Stick of coffee? No, no coffee left. Alright, so, let me see. That's a Chevy one, that's another one, and there's another one, and there's another one. Where are they taxiing? One here, two and three, three and four there. Oh yeah, they made this thing here. It's called formation landing. It's pretty awesome. So, let me speed that thing up here. I guess we can now exit. Okay. Quit. Yes. What did we kill? Oh, first of all, let's see what my wingman killed. Hit. Barbed fence. Shot. Oh yeah, nice. He killed something with the one on. Yeah, just that. Mm-hmm. Barbed fence. Isn't fence not written with an E? Yeah, I don't care. Yeah, he killed some shit here. He likes the bombs. Okay, let me see. What did I kill? Oh yeah, they were shooting at me. They didn't hit me though. Fans. Hey, I do so. You know, in the meantime, I'm the opinion that it's kind of a personal touch of everybody to make typos. So okay, what here? APC hit 30mm. Yeah, hit that. Hit that here as well, that APC. Her name is Kit. Shut it. Body poplar. I have no idea what that was. The GBU-38. That was good. Yeah, the GBU-38. The last one was good. Alright. So we made that mission. Let's see if it crashes again on me. Oh, looks good. Alright, so success rate. Yeah, the second mission really pissed me off. That error. Yeah, okay. It's just a cosmetic thing here. So, gentlemen, thank you for staying here in the channel of non-excellence. That you joined me here in that boring single-player mission, which is actually pretty nice to fly, but not for myself. It's nice to have somebody here to read the chat, to talk to somebody while playing a single-player mission. I'm not so easily immersed here, so I'd rather play multiplayer. But anyway, thank you for staying here. Eventually, I'm coming back online later on with some Hornet on our STP server. We got a campaign mission running there. Well, basically, it's just a huge mission which saved the progress. And alle Hornets belegt. Halt. Saved the progress, and we're playing since a week now at that mission here. So, your quacks. See ya. So, gentlemen, hope to see you all again in the channel of non-excellence. And until then, until the next time. Look at the end. Hey, Twitch Cloak Raindrop, thanks for the follow. And Clear Noise, thanks for the follow. Until the next time in the channel of non-excellence. Goodbye.